Good morning, students. So you already know in your new syllabus one new topic is there, Arab Spring, right? It's new topic. In textbooks material is not available. So with my own knowledge and all, I have prepared this topic. As soon as we will get to know the boundaries of this topic, we can go for one more video covering if that will not be covered here. So let me explain you what is this actually, right? What does this mean? Arab Spring is actually a movement towards democracy which were in Arab countries. So if you will look at the map of Arab nations, you will see how these are linked to each other and how after doing this topic you will get to know how movement which started in one country has been spread in other countries. Okay, so study map in that case. 21st century witnessed emergence of a democratic movement in West Asian countries which we call Arab Spring. That began in 2009. Western media popularized the events happened there as Arab Spring. In Western media, they started using this word, so it became popular. And they started using it in 2011 when they started covering all that. So, when we talk about Arab Spring, there are so many countries and situations and protests happened there can be covered. And the most important among all these is Tunisia, because here spread started actually. Movement started from here. Okay, you need to learn it. It was struggle against corruption, unemployment and autocratic rule of one. Actually, these countries were ruled by undemocratic rule, I should say, one man rule. Autocratic rule was there and there was widespread corruption because of this. And in Tunisia, what happened on 17 December 2010, Mohamed Bouazizi, popularly known as Boss Bossa, fired himself in front of a government office. Now actually, who was he? He was a street vendor, fruit seller. He could not, because of poverty and all very bad economic conditions, he could not, you know, get any employment, could not study for long. So to support his family, he started selling fruits. But policemen, jo ki hamare, you know, jinka role bahut positive hai hamare liye, they were approximate daily were you know, torturing him for you know, bribe and all. So he was fed up of that situation where he could not, you know, usko koi rasta nahi mil raha tha. And what has he done? He planned that I will fire myself in front of any government office. Okay, and he did that. Okay, you may see his, you know, photograph. So he fired himself, and 17 December 2010 it happened. And the very next day, 18 December 2010, protests spread through Facebook and Twitter. Social media, role of social media was great in this, because actually the country was under Ben Ali. He was autocratic ruler, dictator, and actually all this was against him only, his rule only. And he, you know, controlled everything very tightly because of this protest. But it was social media, Facebook and Twitter, through which, through internet, people linked themselves and got to know what happened there, which encouraged them to stand for democracy. So this is very, very important part. After that, what happened? I'm just giving you few clues. Like in Egypt, Hosni Mubarak was there, 30 years ruled. On 25th January 2011, protests started, and within 2 weeks and 3 days, this rule was over. So here it was successful, then it was successful here, then Libya. America took advantage of the movement when in Libya it happened and did air attack with the help of NATO and rebels. and Gaddafi killed by the people. People, those who were protesting killed him, and the rebels started among themselves. But later on, those who protested, they started fighting for power with each other. No organization. And in Saudi Arabia, it spread in March 2011. Later on, after protest, there was Shia-Sunni conflict. Then in next Islam, these Arab countries, it spread. So I hope it will help you to give an overview of this topic, which is very, very important because it is new topic, more scope to ask questions. Thank you so much.